Living Lord in all of his glory. yourself at home in me. Make yourself at home. Make yourself at home. You can make yourself at home in me. There's no better thing than to see your face, to hear you speak. Oh, to hold the King of Kings in all of his glory. Oh, in all of his glory, in all of his glory, in all of his glory. Yourself at home, you can make yourself at home in me. Oh, make yourself at home, make yourself at home, you can make yourself at home in me. Oh, make yourself at home, make yourself at home, you can make yourself at home. Yourself at home, make yourself at home, you can make yourself at home in me. Oh, make yourself at home in me, Jesus. Right here, right now. Make yourself at home, make yourself at home, make yourself. Make yourself at home, make yourself at home, make yourself at home.
Making room for you, Jesus. We're making room. Jesus.
yourself at home. You can make yourself at home in me.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Make yourself at home. Oh, make yourself at home. You can make yourself at home in me. Make yourself at home. You can make yourself at home in me.
Right here, right now.
Make yourself at home. Make yourself at home. You can make yourself at home in me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus, we thank you for your presence. We thank you that you're our ever-present help in times of need. We thank you that we could build our lives upon this foundation. We thank you that we can hang the hopes of our life upon the work of the cross, upon the work of Jesus Christ. God, we yoke our lives to yours. We yoke our lives to yours. We give you all that we are, because you're worthy of it all.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever say. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you, God. And we sing, holy. There is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. Song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever breathe. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, yeah, yeah, we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever say. Oh, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. Come on, let's declare. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes.
Beside you, open up my
reaching, I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation, and I will put my trust in you.
Well, please allow me to say one more time, Merry Christmas and Happy Advent season to you. I'm sure that you're cleaning up your homes, throwing a bunch of wrapping paper into the trash, possibly making plans to take down your tree, not quite yet for sure, but just preparing, looking ahead for 2022. And that's what I'd love to talk with you a little bit about today, the day after Christmas. It's been such a joy doing 2021 together as a family. I'm sitting here today in the fulfillment of God's prophetic word over our house that 2021 was a year of inhabitation. It was a year of expansion. It was a year of taking ground. It was a year of stepping further into our promised lands. And this is a recent acquisition of Legacy Nashville. This is our new house at 908 Preston Avenue, and we're so excited to be growing together. Now, what could God do in 2022? Have you asked yourself that question recently? I hope you're asking yourself that question, because Jesus said, "Nothing shall be impossible with Him." What I'm hoping that we get to do today together is provoke one another to dream and to dream bigger for 2022, to apply Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20 to our lives and how we're thinking about the next season with the Lord, that God truly wants to do more than you could ever ask, think, or imagine in your 2022. Now, I know for some people, this hasn't felt like an amazing year. We could even reflect back on 2020 and think about all of the ups and downs of that year. And so you might be thinking, in 2022, is there going to be more of the same? Is it going to be crazy? Is it going to be weird? Is it going to be wild? Well, it's a guarantee. There's going to be ups and downs. You're going to make mistakes. You're going to go through hard times. But there's also going to be some glorious moments that are going to outshine them all. And we're going to be together for those moments. And God is going to be right there with us, blessing us, protecting us, guarding us, and leading us further into the great things He has for us. So let's prepare for 2022 today together. I've kind of entitled this Dream Sunday. Christmas is over. 2022 is on the horizon. What are you dreaming about for this new year with the Lord? I'm going to read a passage of scripture, short scripture. It's not going to be a long word today, but short passage of scripture that you've probably seen in your mom's kitchen. All right. So it's on all kinds of placards and everything. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. I probably don't even have to read it. You can probably quote it, but I'm going to the ESV as always. Jeremiah 29 and 11 says this, "For I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. Plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope." Can I read it one more time? "I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans for welfare," which in the Hebrew just means plans to prosper you. Let me hear you say that from the couch. Plans to prosper me. Plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope. What if we were to take this passage of scripture today and put it before our eyes, kind of like sunglasses? Like, what if our worldview, what if our lens for 2022 was this passage of scripture? That we could recognize that God has made plans for us in the new year. And those plans are to prosper us, those plans are to give us a good future, and to give us a great hope. Those are the points I want to make to you today. Remember, point number one, as you are thinking about 2022, as you are praying, as you are talking, as you are dreaming, as you are making resolutions and goals, point number one is this: God has plans for you. Come on, let's say it together. God has plans for me. Come on, look at the person next to you and tell them, did you know God has plans for me? What if this year you didn't just write your own resolutions, but you wrote out God's plans? What if you didn't think about what could 2022 hold? What if you prayed and you listened to God's thoughts about your 2022? What if you didn't just make plans? What if you let God make plans for your 2022 and you said, "Here I am, Lord. I want to be in alignment with your plans and I'll obey. I say yes and amen. I'm moving into 2022 just like that." And I believe we're going to get to do that together. God says that He has good plans for your 2022. Why don't you spend some time over the next couple of days, just finishing up Christmas, maybe you're taking down the tree or something. Why don't you spend an hour, 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 2 hours, spend some time sitting with the Lord in prayer. Practice listening to Him and ask Him, "God, would you share with me your plans for me and my house in 2022? Would you talk to me, Holy Spirit, about what the plans of heaven are over my life for this new year?" And I want to challenge you, encourage you, write those down. What are God's plans for your 2022? Don't just make resolutions. Listen to God's plans and write them down. I remember a pastor told me one time, whatever you give birth to in the flesh, you got a steward in the flesh. But whatever you give birth to in the Spirit, the Holy Spirit will work alongside you to bring all of them to fruition, all your plans to fruition. So I want to encourage you, don't just make resolutions, don't just make your own plans, but actually give birth to the plans of the Lord through prayer and partner with the Holy Spirit in 2022 to achieve and execute the plans of the Lord. Now, I know that for some of us, because 2020 or 2021 has been so tragic and just so filled with grief and anxiety and fear, that we may have a problem believing this truth, that God does have plans for us and that they are good, or that God is a good, good Father. For some of us, the last couple of years have given us a temptation to believe that God's not a good father, but that he has somehow, some way become this organized taskmaster bent on putting us through cycles of grief and pain and terror and fear, and that we don't see that God is actually that good. But that's not what Jeremiah chapter 29 and 11 teaches us, and that's not what the Bible has to say about your Savior. The nature of God is good. As Bill Johnson says, God is in a really good mood. God is happy. He who sits in the heavens laughs, Psalm chapter 2 says. God loves you, and he seeks to be good to you, and he is, in fact, in a good mood. So when you're writing down what God has to say to you about 2022, and you write down anything that's pessimistic or evil, know this, that's not from the Lord. God has good things to say to you. And that's point two. God's plans are good, and they're certainly not evil. He says that he cares about your welfare. You know what your welfare is? It's your safety. It's your well-being. It's your happiness. It's your friends. It's your health. It's your prosperity. It has to do with your finances, and it has to do with your peace, that shalom. So when the Bible says that God has good plans for your welfare, the Bible means that God has good plans for you to prosper. God has no plans to do harm to you. He has no plans to cause you to feel unsafe or be unsafe. He has no plans to cause you to be sick. He has no plans to cause you to feel discouraged. He has no plans to ruin your relationships. He has no plan to disrupt your peace. He has no plans to thwart your prosperity. None of those things are in the plans of God as he looks at your 2022. He is thinking, this is my son, this is my daughter, and I have plans to prosper him. I have plans to prosper her. Another word for evil here is to do harm. And I don't know who needs to hear that today, but could you just receive this as a word from the Lord? God has no ill will towards you. He has no motive to harm you or to hurt you. God's will is to prosper you. So let's practice placing that lens before our eyes as we're looking at 2022 in the new year. This is your worldview. God's in a good mood. He wants to be good to me. He wants to prosper me. He has plans for me, and those plans are good. Here's the last and final point, point three. God has already provided for your future. There's a passage of scripture that says that the angels of the Lord actually go before us as God sends us out on assignment. God has already prepared good places for you in the future. You have a promised land, and God has spoken promises over your life, and that future is good. God already knows the beginning from the end from the beginning. He already knows what is going to happen to you. He knows what you're going to go through in 2022. And listen, he's not scared away. He's not weak or feeble. He is passionate. He is in charge. He is strong. He is courageous. And he puts that same spirit into us as he tells us today, I already know what's going to happen in the future, and I've got good plans, and I've made good preparations for you in 2022. He gives us a future. He gives us a hope, church. And remember, Christian hope is not culture's definition, right? Like, I kind of reluctantly hope so. No, Christian hope is different. It's an anchor. It's a stake in the ground. It's not reluctancy. It is confidence. It is surety. It is a deep knowing that God will provide for me. He will perform every promise he's spoken over my life. He is a good God. He's not a man that he should lie. Everything he wants to accomplish, he is going to accomplish. Embedded within God's plan for you is your future, is 2022. And with everybody becoming so futuristic these days, I hope that's not hard to fathom. Like, we've got, you know, Elon Musk with Tesla, and we've got Facebook and the metaverse, and we've got all these things, AI, everybody's trying to predict the future. And unfortunately, most people have this lens over their eyes that the future is bleak, that the future is some sort of post-apocalyptic scenario in which none of us prosper. But that is not what the Bible says. That's what the storytellers of culture tell us, but that is not what the King of Heaven tells us. His plans for 2022 for you are good. Your life will not be cut short. There's no miserable existence for you ahead. You have no good excuse to look around at your life in 2022 with fear and uncertainty. You have every reason to approach this new year with a heart full of expectation, knowing that God has prosperity for you. Lastly, I was remembering this morning that my pastor used to tell me, he said, if your failure was not fatal, then it was not final. If your sin or your mistake was going to be all that was ever written about you, well, God would have allowed you to die and move into paradise in that moment, but that's not the case. He left breath in your lungs for a purpose. He has put the gift of life on the inside of you. You are called. You are anointed. You have an assignment. 2022 is going to be amazing. I think it was Lou Engle that said, you don't have a dream. God had a dream and wrapped your flesh around it. This is what I want to encourage you in today, church. 2022 is going to be an amazing year. So let's remember, God has plans for you. They are not for your harm. They are for your good. They are for your prosperity, to give you a hope, to give you a good future. So take a few moments over the next few days, write down what God's plans are for your 2022, and make a decision in your heart that you're going to go in all in on His resolutions, not just your own, and make 2022 the best year we've ever had together. 2022, the year of growing down, deeper roots, more mature faith, more strength, more understanding of God's plans for our lives together, both as individuals, but as a collective family unit and as a church. I love you guys so much. Me and Pastor Allison love you guys so much. The church, the leadership team, the staff, everybody collectively, we want to say Merry Christmas, Happy Advent. We love you. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, I thank you for every single person that calls Legacy home that's a part of this family. We bless their 2022. And if they have stopped dreaming, we declare in Jesus' name that the dreamer inside, just like Joseph, is coming out of prison this year and is going to dream again. I speak over everybody carrying a dormant prophetic anointing that is resting upon their life. I declare in Jesus' name that their mouths shall be moved to open up again and prophesy and declare the word of the Lord. I declare in Jesus' name over those that used to pray and believe God to heal the sick through their hands. We'll begin to pray again if they have stopped. Those who have left their ministry long ago, that the ministry is coming forth again in 2022. God has plans for you, church. I love you so much. God bless you. Happy New Year. Let's go, 2022.